We're back!
We're hungry!
And we're on National Highway 4, 30 kilometers ahead of Pune, heading down to the town of Kolhapur, which is about 200 kilometers that way. National Highway 4 is a place that you don't have to worry about as far as food is concerned on this stretch. Right where we're standing, there are three dhabas in the immediate vicinity.
And there have been a lot more behind us, all of them offering like a whole range of stuff. Something we've noticed while we've been driving is all of them are advertising something called a bhakri, a chicken bhakri, a button bhakri, a vegetable bhakri.
So either they spelled goat wrong and instead of saying bhakri, they made it bhakri, or else we're going to go and find out what it is and tell you more about it. Another speciality of this area seems to be chicken lalwani, which is probably named after some shopkeeper in Mumbai, but we'll find out more about it. Well, considering the choices are Anand Dhaba, Rohit Garden and Jai Bhavani, and us being the kind of guys we are, we're going to go with Jai Bhavani!
I saw a sign.
When you're heading out on the highway, it's always nice to see a huge sign like this, multicolored, inviting you to come and eat what? If you can't read the writing, at least you can try and understand the graphics.
Because what it says on this sign is special Gavra chicken handi, special mutton handi, special chicken malwani, special mutton malwani, pittal bhagri, jeev richi, and other stuff that we have no idea about, but we're going to tell you more. But before we do, I want to point out to an appalling fact. I've heard it's a dog-eat-dog world out there, but a chicken-eat-chicken? I've never seen that before. They could be related, you know. How could you show this?
Blood sugar a little low. When he's not eaten for a bit, he gets a little hysterical.
Talking about blood sugar, here's my favorite chicken joke. Why did the chicken cut his finger, cross the road twice and roll in the mud? Do you know?
No, but I have a feeling I'm about to find out.
Yes, because he wanted to be a bloody dirty double crosser.
This is what happens when the chicken crosses the road. It becomes Rocky's meal.
And what a meal it is. People in Kolhapur take their food very seriously. Incredible. We've got such a lot of variety over here. I'm going to start with what is undoubtedly my favorite so far on this table. This is the techa or the khada. This smells wonderful. Oh my God. You've got to try this at home. Take about that many green chilies chopped finely, that much garlic, and raw peanuts. That's peanuts that are not yet really ripe and hard. They're a little soft. And you mash them together and then just fry them in a little bit of oil and you come up with this unbelievably good accompaniment for your food. This is fantastic. You ought to try some of this.
Here, rotis are called bakris. What I have here is a jowar bakri and Rocky's got a bajra bakri.
What I've got on my plate over here is a chicken malwani. Incredibly well done. Hugely flavorful. How they do it is they boil the chicken. They retain the stock on one side, chicken on one side. It's cooked completely with all the masalas in it. And the stock is made into this delicious gravy separately, which has onions and whole lot of, that looks like a lot of cinnamon and some incredible flavors because the smell, oh, is brilliant. And when you eat it, you're supposed to mix the two and dip it together and have it. Now remember, in Kolhapuri food, the roti is the essential accompaniment, the bhakri. Rice could be had later, but roti is where it's at.
In dhaba cooking, it's never about measures. There's just a guy there cooking, picking up spices and throwing them in there, and yet he manages to get a really tasty meal.
Tubar.com.